Hi folks, Larry here, Mobile Tech with CanHamTrailers.com. It's time for another weekend update. That spot looks so empty now. That kit trailer, that 1953 kit, was there for a long time and it took up a lot of my back lot. So, it's gone now. Yep, she went to live in California. It's going to be an Airbnb rental on a 12-acre piece of property with a 1-acre pond in the middle. So that should be fun. I'd like to see it when it's all set up. Haven't worked on any of these yet. I just don't have time. So they're just all going to have to sit there for a while. The one in the middle belongs to me. Well, actually, the one in the middle and the one on the right belong to me. That little fiberglass job over there belongs to one of my viewers. And unfortunately, she's gonna have to wait. I gotta get more work done before I can start on that one. This is where the frame goes. The door frame. I have to get that on so I can continue putting these guys up on here. That's the framing. That one's just laying there. In the back here, I've got that one in, and I've got that one in. And there's what she looks like with the door frame installed and the other framing installed. A lot of it you can't see, but there's what you can see. Oh, I really like it. There's the other exposed framing, and there's some in behind that door too. As you can see, that framing is all screwed in, and it's really what gives the trailer some rigidity all the way down here. All these screws up and down, everything's all screwed in. This side's getting really close to being done. See along there? Now I just have to install the windows. They look like over there, the window framing. Install that on this side, and then I can turn this trailer around and begin the other side. Really happy with progress. I'm also building a mock-up. It's kind of messy looking right now, but these lights are actually fastened to the to this piece of metal here and this plywood board, along with license plate and license plate illuminator light. Wires are all hanging there. And then, so that is a mock-up for exterior trailer wiring. I'll have a couple of marker lamps up in these corners here. I'm waiting for those to come in, an amber one and a red one. And then on this side, it's gonna be all the stuff for the interior wiring. And I'm doing this for my class. My class actually got to watch me build this part last night. They're gonna watch me build this part next week at next week's class. And this is how I'm teaching them about the wiring for these vintage trailers, so that they don't electrocute themselves and so that all their wires and all their lights and everything work the first time. As you see, we got marker lights, we have tail lamps, and we have a license plate light. Some people even have like 3 or 4 or 5 marker lights up there too. So all that stuff has got to be pre-wired before the metal goes on. If you don't know what you're doing, it's kind of tough. So I'm teaching my students in a way that they can understand, rather than schematics and diagrams on a whiteboard. I'm just doing it right in front of them and talking about everything I'm doing, what color wires I'm using, why I'm using them, where they go, and I light it all up too. Yeah, it's a really good teaching aid, I think. Definitely fall. I'm starting to lose leaves. They're changing colors here. And oh, there's my peach tree. Oh, I couldn't believe the batch of peaches I got this year. But it's changing colors and the leaves are falling to the ground. It's definitely fall.
Well, that's another weekend update. If you like this video, give me a big thumbs up. If you don't like it, give me a big thumbs down, but let me hear from you one way or the other. But remember, folks, I make mistakes, so you don't have to. We'll see you next time.